It's my great pleasure to introduce Yentle Rangiira. Yentle is known to us because she has spoken before. In fact, a couple of people said, and you spoke last year, which you did. But recently, you and a group of young compatriots went to New Zealand for a youth conference, did you not? Either about the time some of us went to Paris and visited UNESCO. So you're heavily involved in the interfaith movement, and so are those who make up your panel. But would you welcome Yentle to the stage? And she is going to introduce the panellists who are going to be with us for this afternoon. Would you please welcome Yentle?
Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Yentle, and it's great to see all of these familiar faces here this afternoon. And I'd just like to introduce the other members of the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group.
Is it on? Yeah. So, hi, I'm Claire. I just finished grade 9 here at St. Ursula's College.
I'm Lakshmi, and I just finished year 10 at Fairholme College.
I'm Mahsa, Nabizada. I just finished grade 8 in Fairholme College.
I'm Connie Q, and I finished year 10 in Centenary Heights State High School.
Awesome. So, this year has been truly amazing for us, and we've been blessed to have countless opportunities to cultivate and encourage peace in our community. And we have done a lot of listening and learning, which has helped us in the growth of the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group. And this year has been filled with excitement, challenges, friendship, and joy. And I am beyond grateful to be here with this amazing group of young people. The Toowoomba Youth Peace Group all started back after the International Peace Conference earlier on in the year, after a few of us spoke about what peace meant to us. And we have made it our mission ever since to continue to discover what peace means and how we can create this wonderful thing in our community. This next session will follow a set of questions relating to the events and initiatives we have been involved in this year, and will also surround our ideas of what the future of the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group will look like. I would first like to talk with Claire about how she became involved in the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group. Claire, how did you become a member?
So, yeah, I'm the new one. Well, the first time I heard these guys speak was at the International Interfaith Conference in March, I think it was. And yeah, I was in the audience and I heard them talking about their experiences and what peace meant to them. And it was really interesting because they were talking about like how they were youth affected, how they saw peace, and they all had different stories and they were different from mine, which really intrigued me. So I got really interested, and I was talking to my dad about it that afternoon, I think, and I said I was interested in what they had to say and I wanted to get more involved. So he helped me get in contact with Mei Ling, who runs our group. She's lovely. I got in contact with her and she was lovely. She invited me to a meeting, which was a few weeks from then. So I was a bit nervous, but I came. I came to Pure Land College. We're in a little room and I walked in and you guys were so lovely. And you invited me in and told me what was happening. And at that point, you're organising the youth conference, which I think we'll talk about later. And they got me up to speed and told me what was going on. And I felt right at home, which was lovely. I met all you guys and it was really lovely.
So what skills have you learnt in this role? Because throughout the year we have learned so much and we have had the experience of being involved in so many things that we've never even known existed. So can you tell me a bit about what skills you've learned?
Well, the main thing that I helped out in doing, because I only joined about halfway through the year, the main thing I helped out with was the youth conference, which was a big undertaking to say the least. I've never experienced anything like it before. It really opened my eyes to how much work goes into organising a conference just like this. And so we learnt, oh man. There was a lot of, the thing I noticed most was how important was it to make quick decisions, smart decisions, and decisions that benefited everyone. Because we didn't have much time. We had meetings maybe once every 3 weeks, and we had to organise a conference in a short amount of time. But I loved it, and it really, like, it showed me the importance of communication, because it was only once every 3 weeks, and we had to talk to people who were coming to talk and talk to each other about what we think would be best, had to come up with ideas. And it taught me a lot, I think.
Yeah, definitely. And I think organising that conference was a great starting point and gave us a lot of courage, I think, to now be able to create more. And what are your hopes for the future of the group?
For the future? Well, this group's pretty new, and I'm sure this is only the beginning. I'm excited to get more members, and I really hope that in the future we'll kind of spread what we're doing, and we'll get more people involved. Right now we're all only girls, so we might get some boys involved, because it's important to kind of to extend ourselves, like be inviting, because anyone can join, like what we're doing, it's just out of everyone. But I'm hoping that maybe we'll organise more conferences, maybe we'll extend ourselves and try and spread our message.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's important also that we can be the representatives, that all different types of young people can be representatives. So we can have, so many different young people in Toowoomba have stories to share. And I think as long as we can get those stories out, we can continue to create peace. That's awesome. Thank you, Claire. One of the most important things about holding events and initiatives as a group is being able to communicate and promote them within the community. And I'd now like to ask Lakshmi about how we achieve this as a group. So Lakshmi, how does the group advertise our work and our message to the community?
I have a script because otherwise I won't be able to fill in time, but we use various social platforms such as Instagram, Facebook. We've created our own email account and our very own self-developed website created by Connie and also being maintained by Connie. And during the lead up to the youth conference in October, we promoted the event through our schools and placed posters in public vicinities like the library to spread the word. In our schools, we composed mass emails and youth-friendly posters to attract and appeal to our target audience. This was really useful in developing our professionalism. And we have also appeared in the Chronicle several times due to our contribution to several programs, including the International Youth Conference in New Zealand. However, in every approach to promoting an event or the like, it has been challenging to keep advertising attractive and effective.
And what events has the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group been involved in this year? I know you've talked about a few of them, but I think, just tell us a bit about that.
The major events we have been involved in has been the Toowoomba Languages and Cultural Festival, the annual police dinner, and the Heartfulness Youth Seminar. So the Heartfulness Youth Seminar was held last weekend, and we helped in running a few sessions as well as with organising. The Toowoomba Youth Peace Group facilitated an activity called Kahoot and also ran a dialogue session on the effects of social media. The effects of social media was chosen as a topic, as it is a concept that resonates with the youth of contemporary society. Everyone had in-depth conversations on the positive and negative impacts, such as the importance of social media in connecting with people globally and the negative effects due to the lack of regulation in social media. The discussions similar to these are central in encouraging problem solving and creative thinking in youth. The seminar was a chance for us to discuss freely and express our own perspectives. It's been really fantastic attending all these events as it has helped us to develop as a team and form connections.
Can you tell me a bit about our involvement in the Toowoomba Language and Cultural Festival and about the involvement in the police dinner as well?
Yeah, so the group was invited to the annual multi-faith police dinner held on the 1st of August as ambassadors to welcome the honoured guests who serve our community. Fatima, Connie, Carrie and I had the special opportunity to attend dressed in our traditional multicultural outfits. We had the chance to meet different faith representatives and to listen to amazing speakers such as Prudence Mellum, as I'm sure many of you know. I'm mentioning Prudence specifically because she is also youth and she just demonstrates that even young people have influence. She is removing barriers between cultures and communities. Her work opens up possibilities for us to strive to achieve bigger goals and overcoming societal issues. For the Toowoomba Languages and Cultures Festival, which took place on August the 12th, we set up a stall in the multi-faith tent and gave out flyers on information on our upcoming events, the art competition and youth conference. Each member took shifts looking after the stall along with Mei Ling and Mr. Hanif, who have been a huge support in all of our endeavours. We met many people on the day and encouraged them to join in an activity, writing a response to questions we posed to the community about peace. Each new opportunity has played a major role in cultivating our confidence as youth and has been beneficial in our ability to observe the society we live in. We have learnt our individual capacity and our capacity as a team in making positive ripples in our community.
Thank you, Lakshmi. Earlier on in the year, Connie, Rahila and I went on an amazing trip to New Zealand where we attended a three-day multi-faith conference. The conference was truly amazing and taught us so much about other people's stories and even inspired us in creating our own conference. Connie, can you please tell me a little bit about the lessons that you learnt from the trip?
So, over at New Zealand, the National Interfaith Forum, they were separated into 3 days. And over the course of 3 days, we discussed cultural diversity. And I think it was very inspirational for us as we learned a lot about other cultures, and the understanding and the knowledge was kind of passed around and we gained a lot from it. We took some knowledge and understanding back to help us with our youth conference as well, so it was pretty good.
And what are some ways that you think we can bring multi-faith diversity into Toowoomba?
So bringing multi-faith diversity into Toowoomba, we had a youth conference this year, so I think that helps with spreading diversity to our community, broadens our horizons and gives everyone a chance to also gain an understanding of our culture, different cultures, different faiths, and how we could also work together as a community, to spread the word.
Yeah, definitely. I think we need to have more conferences like this throughout the year, especially for young people, so we can learn about their stories and everyone's individual faith journey in whatever that may be. Do you have a highlight from the conference?
So we did meet the South African High Commissioner over on the first day of the forum. She was a very powerful and influential woman. She really inspired us with her approach to creating multi-faith diversity, and she really encourages people to spread the word and try to participate in more activities like the forum and more conferences. Yeah.
Awesome. So this year we also held our own art competition in Toowoomba where anybody interested could submit their work and win prizes. And so this wasn't just for Toowoomba, we actually had submissions from all over Queensland, which was really exciting, and we really enjoyed going through all of the submissions and picking our favourites. Connie, can you tell me about what the purpose of the art competition was?
So our theme for the art competition was convey your thoughts through art on what living in today's world is like, living in harmony. So a lot of talented participants headed in their artworks around the theme of what living in harmony is, as you can see in the PowerPoint. Yeah.
And how successful was the overall competition?
So the competition was overall really successful in its goal, with our planning and process through the regular meetings of our groups. And we also hosted it in addition to the conference with the same goal of bringing our community together. And we made flyers, distributed them at the Toowoomba Languages and Cultural Festival and through our schools as well. And yeah.
Awesome. I think it is so important to be able to include an inclusive range of people in the initiatives that we're involved in because peace is for everybody. And I think that is one of the main messages that we are trying to convey to people as a young group, is that peace is for us young people, it's for old people, it's for everybody, and it does not exclude a race or a religion. And I think that is one of the main messages that we can truly try and get out there to the community, as long as we keep striving for it. Mahsa is involved in the Toowoomba Regional Council Youth Group, and it's really great to see how Mahsa has been able to use her skills from this role and bring them into our group of the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group. Mahsa, what initiatives are you involved in as a member of the TRC Youth Group?
So I'm one of the members of the Toowoomba Regional Council Youth Leaders. The program is young volunteers who self-nominated themselves to represent the voice of the youth in our community to council. They also run projects, and the council asks feedback from us, the youth leaders, on their future projects, if they have any. As part of the role, we are encouraged to address an issue that faces young people or just any group in our community. And this is done by us choosing a project or an event with a budget of $15,000 that's provided by the council for a group of 25 people. And that's shared with the 25 people, and the group can choose whether they run a project themselves individually or they can choose to pool their money and do it as a group. The youth leaders have done a lot. I think it's 4 years old, so it started 4 years ago. We have done music concerts. We've done gardens for elderly people. We've done the Clifton Parks master plan. Similar things. So we've done a lot throughout the years, as well as we also support any agencies that help try to support the youth, and we are go and ask them what their needs are, and then based on that information, we build a project ourselves or as a group.
Awesome. And what skills have you learned from the role?
I've learned a lot. Teamwork would definitely be a major one, because the youth leaders is not just Toowoomba, it's across the region. Teamwork has been big because the youth all have different backgrounds. They've come from different cities. The issues in their cities are different to us. So It was a challenge, but I've definitely learned teamwork, working together with my group. Leadership skills would also be a major one. We do two training camps through the program, and in the training camps, we learn leadership skills, and we taught to serve the people, to serve the young people of the city. I've also learned, and I'm really happy that I've learned this skill because I think it will really benefit me in the future, project planning and developing. As part of the training, a council member, the project planner of the council, came to one of our meetings and shared her skills of developing a project, because it's very important, the processes that you have to take on. I've been happy to learn that skills. In one of the training camps, we went to different agencies that help the youth of Toowoomba who are struggling, because there are several issues that, and the youth are going through a hard time, I would say. There's several issues that is facing them, abuse, being homeless. There are a lot of issues, so it was really nice to see these agencies who the people volunteer, who have self-volunteered to serve the young people.
Awesome. And I think these initiatives are so great, and the first idea I remember in the first meeting that we ever had as a group, we all wrote down what the youth's interests are, and from that we created the name The Next Step, and this was going to be the name of our first initiative in Toowoomba, and this is what people were going to know us as. And the whole idea of The Next Step is that as young people, it is easy for us to identify the issues that we have in the community, such as bullying, cyberbullying, and the idea of The Next Step is that, okay, we can identify these issues, we can be really mad about them, but what can we do to create change? How can we be the next step to peace in our community, in the young community? And it's really exciting, and I think it's powerful when it comes from a youth perspective, because we have so much to share and we have so much to learn at the same time. And creating this conference was more than a conference to us. It was the next step. And this conference that we had in October taught us so much, and the skills that we learned leading up to it, I know that we will use as we continue to create new initiatives and be part of them, and as we are striving for peace more so. So I'd just like to ask you guys some questions about the conference. Mahsa, can you tell me what the goal of the conference was?
The youth conference on October, it was planned by us and organised by us, as well as it was kindly supported by the Toowoomba Interfaith Working Group and the Goodwill Committee. The theme of the conference was what we influence versus what influences us. We wanted to create a chance for young people to network with each other and meet new people and build relationships with people who would have the same notion as them of building peace and are interested in the same things. We had amazing, inspiring speakers from across the region. We had activities and we had workshops. For me, the goal we wanted was to create a platform for these young people who want to make a change in the community. It was, the goal was youth development, youth involvement in the community, youth engagement to empower the youth who want to do something. And I would look at it as though right now I'm speaking to you guys and you're all giving me attention, and that's why I'm speaking to you, I'm continuing to speak. But if you guys didn't look at me, if you didn't want to listen to what I was saying and you just looked away, then I would stop. And that's the same with the youth. If they want to do something and they want to say something, they want to have a voice, and the people are ignoring what they're saying, then they would get discouraged. So we wanted to create a platform where they're welcome to talk, they're welcome to share their voices, and basically, a platform for them.
Definitely. And I think one of my highlights from the day was the very simple, at lunchtime we put some songs on and everyone just got up and started dancing. And I think that in itself is youth peace. And I think that is what encourages us to keep going and to keep moving, is the friendship that is created. And I think that's what the world needs a little bit more of. Just the simple friendship and the dancing and the music is what really inspired me definitely throughout the day. And I think it really is those simple things, those simple acts of peace. So, Claire, what are your hopes for the future of the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group conferences?
Well, for me, I came in about after the planning had started, and as soon as I came in, you guys caught me up to speed with everything that you were doing and your plans for this conference, and I saw potential. I was really impressed, and it was a real eye-opener for me that we can do this kind of stuff. It's a small group in a room at Pure Land College, and we were coming up with all these ideas and all these plans to really get the youth of Toowoomba together and take the first step into pushing us towards the main goal, which was peace. It's just one word, but that's what it is. And I really loved how, what you put into having the youth, and how you realise that youth is an important factor in maintaining a peaceful and healthy environment in Toowoomba, because we're the future of it. The youth will be living here, and the decisions that are being made now are going to affect us in the future.
Definitely.
So with these future youth peace conferences, I just really hope that they grow, basically. I really hope that we get more people. If it becomes an annual thing, that'd be lovely, and we'll really expand our boundaries and get our message out to more and more and more people. And I just think that's a really important thing to finally, we'll kind of get that foundation ready for a good future for Toowoomba.
Definitely. I think now we have the responsibility to keep pushing forward and breaking down new boundaries that we may face. And as long as we keep striving for peace, I think no matter what we're doing, we can have an impact on at least one person's life. And as long as we keep pushing, we will create that. Lakshmi, we all learnt so much from the experience of running the conference. What was something that you gained from the whole adventure?
Well, as an organiser, from my kind of perspective, in organising the event, it was a great learning experience of how people interact and how we have to approach each different situation critically. And doing all the behind, background work, it teaches one humility, and it's important to remember to do the work that needs to be done rather than trying to gain the acknowledgement for it. And one of the more obvious things that we also gained was the importance of teamwork and playing to each other's strengths. So when one person may not be so confident with something, another person will be, which was really lovely. And we definitely bonded as a as a team over time, because we did get to spend quite a bit of time leading up to the conference, and it was really good.
Awesome. There was a lot of stress, especially in the days leading up to the conference. I remember frantically running around home, like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And I think it does get to a stage where we all knew that we had put so much work into it, so much effort, all of these months, all of this planning. And it got to those few days before, and I know we were all so stressed, and we just wanted it to be everything that we had imagined. And I remember having a conversation with my mum, and she was telling me that it's all just going to work out. And I think the reason that it all worked out is because we have each other and we have all of our individual strengths. And getting there on that day, we were all just so excited to get involved and greet the people as they were coming in and hanging up the artwork on the walls. And so I think what's really been so special in this group is that we have all been able to grow together, and it wasn't just a case of us getting together and creating peace, it was also us getting together, figuring out what peace actually means to us, and then being able to live that out in our lives. And I think that's the best way that we can encourage it for other people, is to firstly live that out for ourselves. The conference did take a very long time to come into fruition, actually. I think straight after the conference in March, we all decided that we wanted to create the group, because we weren't a group before then. And from then, we decided to start the conference planning and everything. So, Connie, how long did it take to plan the conference, and what were some obstacles that you faced?
So from March, where we formed the group, until October, so that's around
a while.
Yeah, a while, quite a while. I'm mathematically challenged, sorry. But it was quite a long process, very hectic, a lot of work to be done, especially since with our like social platforms as well, the promotions, and trying to get the program together. It was quite challenging on what we needed to provide for the people who came, and what we were going to give to them, and how we were going to, you know, spread the peace in our community. Yeah.
Definitely. Awesome. So do we have any questions? Just one. Let's hope it's a good one. Oh, awesome. Okay, sweet. So the question is, which faith are you from, and how do you think that members of your youth community see interfaith, peace, and harmony? Well, for me personally, I am a Catholic. And the second question, how do you think the members? Okay, so I think that a lot of young people don't really see the purpose of interfaith, peace, and harmony in our community, if I'm honest. I think a lot of people don't understand what that means and how it can affect everybody. And I think part of our journey and part of our mission is to show people that they do have a voice, and that that voice will be valued by the people who are listening to them. And I think that's what's so great about these conferences, is that we're able to listen to one another and take things from that and take the things that resonate with us and learn from that. And so I think, a lot of our goal is to help people understand that interfaith peace and harmony is important, and it's for everybody. So, Claire, what faith are you from, and how do you think the members of our youth community see interfaith peace and harmony?
So, I'm a part of the Baha'i faith.
And what was the second part of the question?
It's a bit of a tricky one. How do you think that members of our youth community see interfaith peace and harmony?
Well, of course, it's that people usually generally see peace as, unfortunately, some people see it as the unattainable goal that's kind of a term that's just thrown around there. But yeah, I find that kind of happens with the youth, and I think it's really important that we get everyone together and share our stories and kind of help everyone realise that it's attainable and you can create peace in your community, but it doesn't have to be the stereotypical picture of peace that comes into everyone's mind when you think of it. We need to kind of define it a bit, define it as a simpler kind, as a simpler thing that you can just do in everyday life.
Definitely.
Like, peace is just, it's really easy when you think about it. Well, it's just mutual love and respect for one another and the acceptance.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that it's an attainable goal to with the youth to show them that peace is right in front of you. You're just going to have to kind of take hold of it.
Definitely. So. And Lakshmi, which faith are you from, and how do you think that members of our youth communities see interfaith peace and harmony?
So technically, by heritage, I am Hindu. Thanks. And I feel as though by putting a label on multi-faith or interfaith, that's automatically creating a division, sort of. So it's nice, like with the youth conference, we just said youth peace conference, left it at that, and it's more important to connect in a humane, like as humans, rather than based on religion and, yeah, I don't know. It's a bit tricky to answer that question.
Yeah.
But interfaith is definitely important, trying to understand other people's identities and how where people have originated from and different cultures and, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, and I think it is different. I think the interfaith discussion is different for young people because I know everybody's still growing in their own faith journey in themselves, but as young people, I think especially we are still trying to figure out who we are, let alone what we believe in. And so I think it is a lot easier in our conferences to have the goal of them to be peace. And if interfaith discussions come up, that's great, that's what the youth wants, and we can talk about that. But at the end of the day, we're striving for peace first, and the interfaith diversity, I think that will come with that. So, Mahsa?
I am a Muslim, a proud Muslim. How do you think the members of community see interfaith? So I would agree with Yentle, not many youth know or they haven't participated, so I think it's very important to get the youth involved. And it could just mean coming to this conference or coming to a youth peace conference, and then they influence each other or they promote it with their youth. Youth is a very significant part of the community, and their involvement is very, very important. I think we'd all agree that with the involvement of our youth, it can only assure us a better future, a more peaceful future, because power will be handed to the next generation. And I would fear a leader that has no understanding of its community, of the people that live in the community, because interfaith, multicultural is part of Australia. It can't be ignored because that's what it is. So it's very important to create a platform for youth encourage them to get involved in the community so they know what's coming. And strong leaders start from young leaders. So, yeah, I think it's very, very important to get us involved, and we would appreciate your help and appreciate your encouragement.
Awesome. Connie?
So, I'm Buddhist. I'm a Buddhist, and the youth community, I think of it as, is very significant in our society, because we are the young, we are the youth, and there are more generations of young people to come that will shape our world and our cultures and how we think in the future, and you know, for the years to come. Right now, if you were to, so, for example, I'm a Buddhist, and not a lot of people really believe like religiously. So if like during school and like I'll be like, you know, because being Buddhist, I'm vegetarian as well. So sometimes, you know, dietary requirements, and then people would like ask, oh, why are you vegetarian? And I'll be like, I'm a Buddhist. And then they get surprised about that, I guess, because not, you know, like our society, they don't really have a very a foundation of understanding what how our religious society works. And I think that's, you know, the fine line between, you know, religious beliefs and, you know, how our community thinks. I think it's really great that we're doing this, spreading the word and helping our society become aware to what we're doing and how we could live together in harmony. It's not very different from, you know, us with religious beliefs and people who have secular worldviews. We could live religiously and harmoniously together in peace because of our thinkings and how, you know, we share the one idea of what peace is. So, yeah.
Awesome. Now, we've actually got 7 questions, which is super exciting. So the first question is, what is your strategy to get boys involved, and why do you think they have not got involved yet? Does anybody have any ideas?
I think it's very important for both genders to participate at such a thing, because if our members are only girls, then I'm afraid it will be a bit more challenging to also talk with the boys and understand who they are, because if we have members from the male, then I think it will be easier to communicate with young boys. So yeah, I think it will really benefit our group if we had males as well. And I think we, on our Facebook page, we do Facebook promotion. I think sooner we'll have like a notice where we open to any members who would like to give an application to us. And we would definitely accept that, and we hope to have male members in our group as well, because I think it would be interesting to have their perspective as well, and not just us females.
I think it's important if we do gain some guys in our group, because we do need a broader view on what's attractive to youth, and you know, it might be a bit of a barrier for people to approach us if we are all girls. And I think we, in terms of trying to attract more guys, I think we just have to try and expand our social circles and maybe spread the word a bit more and get people more generally interested in what we are doing. I think guys at the moment, because...
Video youth, games? No, I'm sorry.
As youth, they're not as inclined to what we are at this point in time. So I think that's the main reason maybe we haven't gotten as many guys involved in what in our initiative. So, yeah.
I definitely agree. The next question is, was there a particular moment in each of your lives that led you to your own, that led to your journey towards interfaith peace and harmony? For me, I think the conference in March was really special because Mum had asked me, look, Sophie Ryan is trying to find some young people to talk at the conference. Can you think of anyone? I was like, nah, I don't really know. I don't really know any young people. And Mum was like, oh, well, I actually just sent her an email to say that you would do it. And I was like, a 15-minute speech. I was like, yeah, whatever. Let's see. And by... just doing that, I didn't realise the impact that that was going to have. In fact, at the moment, I thought that might just be a one-off. And I got there to that conference and I realised, gee, this is really powerful. And there are some young people who are just as passionate about some of the topics as I am. And we had never met each other before. We all just did our little speeches and kind of left. And I think just that very act of getting up there and speaking, for me personally, showed me, wow, I think I'm going to get myself into my own journey now of discovering what my interfaith journey might look like and even what the journey of the group will look like. And so I think as the year has gone on, and we have continued to be inspired to say yes to the opportunities that has been given to us. I forgot the question. Yeah, I think our journey will keep evolving and will keep teaching us many lessons. So does anyone have anything to say about it? Do you want me to repeat the question? Well, was there a particular moment in each of your lives that led to your journey towards interfaith, peace, and harmony?
Well, for me, I don't really think it was a moment. I've been so lucky to grow up with such a lovely family and such lovely people who have taught me the importance of acceptance of everyone, no matter who they are, where they come from. And that's just kind of the idealism that I've kind of grown up with. And the first time I really got involved in this, well, because I'd heard about it before, because my dad is on the interfaith working group, and so I've been around it. But the first time I really got involved was at this conference in March, when I just came and watched before we went on holiday. And so I came and I watched, and it was when these guys were talking, and like they were sharing such incredible stories, and they were nothing like my stories. They were different. They'd experienced different things and they saw things in a different way, but they all spoke so well, and it all just made sense. And it really inspired me. That's why I wanted to join this group in the first place. And it made me want to really contribute to this, to like, go a bit extra, yeah, and just kind of like I want to dedicate more of my life to creating this thing that will be good for everyone.
Yeah, awesome. Does anyone else have any points? Okay, the next question is, what are the plans for 2019?
We want a bigger youth conference where youths not only from Toowoomba but from across the region can get involved, because as before I said, youth involvement is very important and I am very passionate about it, because See, religion for many of us is a lifestyle. It's not just something you do and then you don't do it. It's part of a life. It's our lifestyle. So I think it's very important for each of us, and especially for the youth, to know many religions and to understand each other. Because when you understand each other, you work better.
Awesome. Also, working internationally, we went over this with Mr. Hanif at the Heartful North Youth Seminar as well. We'd like to work more internationally to broaden our horizons, you know, like our trip to New Zealand earlier this year and gaining more experience and knowledge.
Definitely. The next question is, you have spoken about your message and spreading your message. What is your message? There are so many messages. Does anyone have anything?
I feel like I'm talking too much. But my message is acceptance. It's simple. You accept each other for who they are, because it's a human right to believe in what you want to believe in. And to I'm a Muslim, and I was born in Afghanistan. 4 years ago when I came to Australia, I've encountered situations where it's not on purpose that people don't know or have discriminated someone else because of their religion or culture. I think it's because they don't know, they don't understand. So my message is to accept everyone, and education is a big part of it. I think people need to be educated, because it's been oversaid, but education is the key, and it can't be changed. So,
okay. I think as a group, our main message would be the importance of youth and the influence that we can have on society and overcoming issues that we think are playing a bigger role in today's society. So, yeah, I don't know. Pretty simple, but yeah.
Yeah, I think our message is simple. It's, at the end of the day, it's peace. And peace is like here in the brainstorm, and we have so many subtopics that come out from that. And I think that's why it's hard to pinprick one idea or one message, because we have so much that we want to get out there, and we have so much to share as young people, and I think that's really exciting. So the next question is, please can you share details of your website / Facebook, Instagram platform so we can see what you do and support you? Okay, I can't remember all the names. I think you're on the Instagram. I know, I think I'm on the Instagram. I can share the Instagram. I'll just have to grab it up.
The website. So, I forgot.
The Instagram name is thenextstep.twbyouth. I'm hoping to post some more. I just haven't been very active on it, and we don't have many followers, so that'd be really cool if you could follow us.
The Facebook page is Toowoomba Youth Peace Group, and we'd love it if you follow us. And if you have any questions or inquiries, you can message us through Messenger, and we would get back to you as soon as possible and try and help. Connie is getting our website. On Facebook. So when we had the youth conference, we posted the event details, or if anything came up, the registration details, and we try and post as often as possible. And so if we do anything, we'll try and post it on Facebook. So if you do miss the event, you can see our Facebook page and get the details. Yeah, and when we had the art competition, people had questions, and they messaged us through Facebook, and we were very happy to get back to them as soon as possible.
the website, we can hold off that one. That's all right. The next question is, do you see peace as something that can last or something that must be continuously recreated and reinvented? Interesting. For me, wait, do you have the website?
For the question the Yentle said, I'll continue with that. I think the role of the youth is to refresh, renew, and maintain. And I think peace would also come up. That's what I think. I think peace needs to be maintained and also built in our community, because getting perfect peace is something that needs to be worked towards. Peace is different to everyone individually. Peace could be at your mind. I'm peaceful internally. I'm peaceful individually, or it could be at a global peace in different countries. In war zone countries, it's harder. Peace for them is something they need to work very hard for, and it's something that they always want that. And sometimes we take peace for granted, but I think we need to work more towards peace, and it also needs to be maintained, because a lot of work has been done to achieve where we are right now, but we could always improve.
Awesome. Yeah, well, I guess peace is kind of relative. Like, it means a different thing to different people, because people grow up in different ways, they have different opinions, and I think it's different comparing to what time you're in, I guess, because, well, like, everything's evolving, science is evolving, we're discovering new things, medicine's evolving, health's evolving, and they're all going to affect our world. And if we don't find a way to navigate a healthy relationship with other people through all these changes, which are happening pretty fast these days, I don't think it'd be very successful in maintaining peace. Mm. So, yeah.
I think we have to stay relevant, but I think at the end of the day, the morals stay the same. It's just the way of getting the message out there is going to change. But I think, the heart is where it is. So as we... I don't think, like, the idea of peace has to be reinvented or recreated. I think it just has to be maintained.
Just to add to that, sorry. Yeah. When I heard on March, when I heard of this conference, it was send an email to all the youth leaders, and they asked whoever wants to volunteer to come. When I read the title of the conference, International Interfaith Peace Conference, I was like, I didn't know what to think of it, because what I knew about peace was peace could mean someone's life, death, or for them to live. That's what I knew of peace. I knew of war zone countries. And then when I thought of it, what it could mean here, because I think we are safe here. We're not at a life-threatening situation. I thought it meant peace between different communities living in one country, because it is challenging. And right now, I think Australia is the model country of multiculturalism and interfaith, because there are so many different cultures and different religions, and sometimes it's challenging for all of those different people, because different culture could mean people with different ideas, different faith could mean people with different beliefs, and for them to work as one could be challenging to some communities, but... I think Australia is doing very well now, but yeah, that was my first impression.
Yeah, definitely. The next question, which is the last one, is music is such an important part of youth culture. Please, could you each share with us a song that inspires you as young women? I have a song. We listen to it in the car all the time. And I don't know where we got it from. I'll have to ask Mum later. But there's a band. Oh, I think she... I don't even know. But there's a band and they're called Kiakaha, which means something in Maori. It means be strong. And they have a song and it's called Peace / Afiomai. And it's just really powerful. And yeah, I put it on and I feel strong and empowered. Do you have a song, Claire?
Well, I guess peace kind of coincides with happiness. I'll feel happy when I'm listening to ABBA in the car.
trying to think. I do like listening to Don't Worry, Be Happy, the old classic 80s song.
I think most of you would know a song called This Is Me. It's kind of, yeah, I think I like listening. The first time I listened to it, I was so shocked. I was like, this is the song for me. I'm going to listen to it for the rest of my life. Because this song talks about how this is me. I have these scars that are part of me. I have things that are part of me, and it could be different with someone else, but this is me, and I would love myself, and I would hope that the song talks about how if you're going to accept me, this is who I am. I'm not going to change to be accepted, and I'm not going to change to ways that suit you. So,
I don't really have a song that inspires me, but yeah, music is a very big part of my life. Yeah.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. Oh, me say, oh, me tell you to run.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Well,
I would like to hold my little hand. How about we run? How about cry?
Recognize that song? It's from Matilda. Alrighty, so now we're going to have the dialogue circles, which we're hoping to get everyone clumped into three groups behind like the tables, and we're going to have conversations about how the youth group, how we can promote peace and harmony in the community. And so we'll have the group one will be facilitated by Connie and Sophie, and group two will be facilitated by Lakshmi and Mahsa, and then group three will be facilitated by Claire and myself. And pretty much in this session, we'd just like to get everybody's ideas and their hopes for our group, and even if they have any other questions. And we've got some paper and some pens, so anyone can write anything down, any thoughts they have, and yeah. And so at the end, we're going to gather everyone's ideas and then go through them and have a little bit of a discussion at the end. Alrighty. So, yep, group one, group two, and group three.
Love's the root of life. Love's the core of wisdom. Life without love is a life forever falling in the endless night, drifting in a sea of pain. A love for the dawn that leads to one sunny spring. God is virtuous and kind. God is almighty, and you teach us true meaning of love. Being selfless, we offer to help all beings. You give us wisdom, and I am forever grateful. With sacred virtue and purity, God loves all beings. You teach us ethics. With fraternity, compassion, God loves all beings. You teach us morals. Sincerity, loyalty, God loves all beings. You teach us.
So we had some really great conversation actually in the group, and we had some really interesting points as well. So one of them was that the Toowoomba Youth Peace Group goes and finds other youth groups to get involved that might be speak higher. Oh yeah. So yeah, one of the ideas was that we go out to other youth groups, in other faith traditions in Toowoomba, and try and get them involved in our conferences, etc. Do you want to do every second one?
Well, there was a bit of a discussion about kind of like just sort of transferring the energy, because there's a lot of different, I feel like, because you can put out flyers, you can promote your thing, but the only way you're really going to get people to come to these things and get everyone involved is by like kind of expressing your energy and like excitement and getting people involved. Like,
definitely. We had a suggestion for jungle trekking and bushwalking, where we can just have activities like that to get young people involved and having fun in the community.
Yeah, and a big part of it was that we need to get boys involved, because, we've only got one side of the coin here. We need to get that other perspective, get other people's ideas, and yeah, we need some different people.
Definitely. We had a suggestion for a talent show where everyone can come up and, you know, share their talents with each other, which I think would probably create a lot of conversation. It would be, you know, a lot of fun.
There was a point that was really interesting. It's not just putting on our own conferences. It's also important that we attend other ones, because other people have their ideas too, and it's important that we look at these people and learn from them and communicate with them, because they're trying to do the same thing.
We had a statement about hope, and somebody said that
it's kind of like the youth is hope.
Yeah, that from the whole session, what they took from it was, you know, the hope that they have for the future. And that was really encouraging. And I think may we always know hope. Maybe we keep being hopeful for the future, especially as young people. Do you remember that idea? Yeah, so also at the conferences, there was another idea that we have the main theme and then we have like an abstract where we can get different people to come up and share a bit of a snapshot of what that theme means to them, because it's so important to get other people's perspectives on different issues concerning youth. And yeah.
We had ideas, well, just kind of to improve on our last conference, like putting in some more competition and those kind of activities that will kind of appeal to youth and kind of get them excited.
We had a suggestion to send letters to faith leaders in Toowoomba and hopefully get them to support us or get some youth involved for us. And yeah, it's all about creating new connections with people, so I think that would be a really great step in that direction. I don't know what that is. Just say open forum.
So I love the idea of the open forum, just an informal, just getting a whole bunch of people together, youth and whatever background, whatever race, culture, and just speaking their mind, just kind of using their intuition to talk about, well, maybe there'll be a theme. Sometimes there won't even be a theme. There'll just be things that they're interested about and just discuss it with the group, similar to what we just did then, but just a way to express what their opinions and see if they can help out.
Definitely. So those were all of our ideas that we got from a group. Group one, I think we were. Four.
We were one.
We were a group. All righty. Do the next people want to come up?
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. I think Sophie and Connie are ready to go. So we'll hand over to Sophie and Connie. The group on the far side. One do you want?
We could have one each. Short,
so. Well, we can grow it or shrink it.
Yeah, we have a slight height difference between us.
Okay.
So from the first group, we had a lot of similar ideas, you know, great minds think alike. But the main topic, I think, that we talked about was I expressed my ideas on our group and what we were doing and our hopes for the future. And we discussed the topics, you know, on some faults, some mistakes that we may be making, and how we could improve it, how we could overcome these issues and become a better us to help society. Yeah.
We also, some broad picture ideas that were thrown out in our group about how we might be able to improve the youth group going forward are things like clarifying the key messages and objectives that the group wants to achieve and propagate for others in the community, and coming up with ways in which the group can figure those out within them as well. We also spoke about ways that the group might be able to challenge traditional modes of engagement within the community and look to other ways that we can create spaces for young people to engage over important topics of conversation. And also, at the end, we came back to the importance of not trying to reinvent the wheel as a youth group, and therefore engaging with other people in the community. And the last group also touched on this, about engaging with other people who have already started in this space and how we can really build upon the foundations that do exist to move forward together. Anything else you'd like to add, Connie? We have a long list of ideas that we came up with as a group, but in the interest of time, we thought we'd share a broad brush overview. Okay. the issues that we were touched on. So they were like, so we, the way that we documented what we spoke on was we documented some practical ideas that we could work on within the group, and then also broader issues and broader ideas that we can work on within the group. Again, at the top of our list, we have engaging more boys in the steering group, and that's how we that was just a topic that came up early on. The way in which was suggested by numerous people within our group to address that was to look to different modes of engagement, like, for instance, building upon the art competition idea, looking to other modes as well, for instance, like sport, music, dance, drama, and then also other modes of engagement other than conferences, looking to potentially other spaces in which you might engage. And we didn't go into too much detail as to what those might look like, but rather a point that the group might be able to brainstorm on more. Connie, do you want to have a, would you like to address some of the specific ideas that we went through as well?
So for more, you know, exposure to society and how we could help, so more, you know, we could connect with other youth groups in our communities, you know, and other schools, going to schools and speaking with them, you know, on what interfaith is and what peace is, you know, also hold events, you know, like our art competition, so like music or songwriting competitions, you know, poetry, drama, dance, something like that to get more of the community involved using creative arts. It's a very good way to get the community inspired and, you know, hooked into what we're doing. Essay competitions, so, and sport, because sport is a very huge part of our culture as well. We could also use that to connect with people in our society.
I think that wraps up our report back.
Okay. Now we're going to hear from Lakshmi and Mahsa. They were the middle group, and certainly they were engaged too, because I managed to listen in the background to each of the groups and everyone was engaging with each other, which was very good. So, who's going to have the hand mic and who's going to use the lectern? Which one are you going to use?
Okay. Do you want to go first?
You go first.
Okay, so I'd like to thank my group because we had really great discussions. One of the points that came up was to attract more people through speaking at religious organizations. So like going to a church and like telling about our group and telling what we're doing, and that way we can attract more people and get like more contacts.
One of the ideas to attract boys was maybe to attract specifically older, as the older bracket of youth, as they might be more interested in what we are doing in the community.
Came to get members closer, camps get members closer. So if we have a group of people and we organize a camp like during the weekends or the holidays, it will help us become more closer.
Maybe encouraging our personal friendship groups to get involved in this kind of in these kind of activities, and maybe engaging them and spreading our connections through school and that kind of thing.
It was also I'm part of the Toowoomba Regional Council youth leaders, so maybe we could have like a session where the youth peace group could you know, have a meeting with the Toowoomba Regional Youth Leaders Council, and because both of them are like-minded people who you know want to contribute to the community. So yeah, that's something we'll definitely do.
And another idea was organizing simple activities like a soccer match or clean up at Queen's Park or something simple like community service activities to encourage just acts of kindness and that kind of thing.
An interesting one was to teach like your language and like food to peers or just anyone. So cooking classes or something. I'm not a good cook, but my parents are, so they could have a cooking session. And I speak Persian, so maybe, you know, I could try and teach my peers like some words in Persian or.
With our social media accounts, we got a pointer maybe to add more, post more pictures and things to show people what we are doing on a regular basis so that it's more active, our social media accounts.
And we were focused on the youth conference before, and the youth conference is finished. And so now we're looking at participating at, similar events throughout Queensland and Australia, and like sharing our group, just going there and meeting new people and building connections with people and maybe partners. So yeah.
And we had a statement. And it's people inspire people, and I think that's really beautiful, simple, concept of how important it is for us all to connect on a basis like this.
Because the other group said a lot of that.
Yeah.
We still have time. We were thinking of like getting on board with similar minded people. Like if it's schools, maybe going to our piece and like talking with people who are interested in contributing to the community and like asking them what peace means to them, and then maybe organizing an event based on their perceptions, something that they're interested in. And something a member of our group, they said when organising an event, you have to look at people, place and perspective. So, you know, the place you're going to and the people and their ideas and their perspective of peace, because I think it's different to everyone. I think that sums up our points. I hope that helped. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Would you once more thank Claire, Lakshmi, Connie, Mahsa, Yentle, and also Sophie, who helped us out in this particular part of the program. Would you please thank them once more for the very fine job that they've done. And I'm sure they, on behalf of them, I'd like to thank everyone present, because the engagement, I think, has been something which they are able to respond to. A lot of good ideas have flowed, a lot of thought has been offered, and so it'll be interesting to see what develops over the next 12 months, for example, and see how we go. But every encouragement that we can give is certainly important, and we'll see how things develop. Right now I'm padding, but I was just wondering, because we are now ahead of time, we started behind time, and we've managed to catch up and go past, but I'm wondering, John, if you'd like to come forward now and offer the conference summary. John, as you know, John Agnew is a member of the Toowoomba Interfaith Working Group. He's also the chair of Downs and Toowoomba Churches Together, and it has been part of what's been happening with Pure Land and these conferences for quite some time. So I thank John for offering to do this. And John, you've got probably more time than you thought you had. Would you welcome John?
So we've had a pretty good 2 days, but some of you haven't, well, most of us, I think, have been here for the 2 days, but we've had a... much information. It's almost information overload, but... So I suppose to me, we've had a number of challenges throughout the 2 days. But the big challenge for me is how I unpack what we've been, has been given to us, what we, all the information that's been given to us, and what we do with that. We can go home and that was a great couple of days and forget about it. Or we can try to implement some of those challenges, some of that information that we've gained, and implement it in our lives so that it can influence others. So we started off yesterday, and Bishop Cam, and it started off with the theme, we are one, but we are many. And he challenged us, what does that mean? What does that mean for you? And what does it mean for me? We are diverse, but even in that diversity, we're in many ways, we're not one. But throughout that diversity, we can do two things with it. We can use that diversity for good, and that's one of the challenges that hope that we encourage you to take up. But we could also use that for division. Now, hopefully we, not too many of us or any of us would do that, but that's a real possibility, and you can. Diversity can be used as a division, and we see that in society. And one of our aims from conferences like this is to try and bridge those divisions so that we really can. And then we'd be able to say, we are one, but we are many. And then Cam went out on a limb and he tried to teach. I shouldn't say tried, should I say, Cam? He got us singing a song. And I'm not sure how you thought it went, but it didn't go too bad, I thought. But through all of that, it's through the diversity, it's an understanding of who we are and what we are. And we are challenged to learn something new, and when we take on that something new, as I said earlier, what we do with it. Then we moved on to inclusive growth, to an inclusive society, and we was looking at a quality of life and how this can be influenced by education, and I suppose also how it can be influenced by our affluence or lack of, or our poverty. Talked about multiculturalism, and through that there's a great, there's diversity, there's difference, there's identity. A new word for me, hybridity, exclusivity or inclusivity. And so through all that, are we willing to give up some privilege that we have for inclusivity? Are we prepared to take, if I take the word from the youth, take a step, are we going to close our eyes, or have we got the courage, and are we prepared to open our eyes and just look at those new possibilities and those new ideas? And then we had an address, Pathways to Peace, the role of secular institutions in interfaith and understanding. And in that we looked at and was told that the voice does matter, and it's how we put our voice, or how we can better put our voice out into the community. And how do we get other people to listen? But perhaps we need to start with, how do we listen to other people? And sometimes we shouldn't, but we make judgments. And we were told that we really shouldn't look at universities as an enemy, but rather they could be somewhere where we could or could be planted a seed. Promoting social harmony in a diverse community. So we can do that, and we can promote that individually as ourselves. And part of that is, as I covered really by Cam at the start, but we need to look at who we are and where we're going, but then collectively we can influence, and there is strength in working in groups and with others. And sometimes we get restless or get that harmony isn't happening as quick as we might like. But harmony is a work in progress, and it's only as we think about it for ourselves, but talk about it and dialogue with other people, that we're going to get that progress. Diversity is bringing people together with joy and understanding, promoting the well-being of the whole. The collective learning process helps building well-being as we see others as equal and overcome the obstacles of our society. But as we identify those obstacles, really the best way to get over them is not to go around them, but to have a dialogue about it and have a discussion about it. If we go around it, we really haven't. The obstacle's still there. So it's about promotion of that dialogue so that we can have true peace and harmony. And part of those qualities of that is kinsmanship, harmony, sincerity, mutual trust. If we don't trust each other, well, it's really not going very far, but trust is something that's not a given. It's something that we build up. It was as we talk and fellowship with one another, then we get that trust and respect. And it's when we've got that, that others will listen and look to what we're doing. And talked about God sent messages out of love for all of us. And so we are really... we mightn't like to think that, but we really are his ambassadors. We are his ambassadors for peace. And that, as of we seem to say over and over again, it begins with ourselves. All religion has a lot in common. And so we need to respect that and understand that. And we need to be able to communicate that to each other, but we also need to be able to communicate that to the wider community. So then we talked about the importance of building relationships and trust in today's society. And the example there that was given of that mother-child relationship, how a mother loves her child or a baby, and it's through that love that that child then begins to trust the parent or the mother. And so that's an analogy of how we can go out and talk about peace and harmony through interfaith relationships. And it was said that
Without peace and harmony, our whole fabric of society is at risk. But the virtues and importance of unconditional love through us will be an influence in our society. And we were encouraged to read our holy scriptures, which emphasises and expands on those virtues. Then we Confucius and the way of friendship, wisdom of Confucius. Confucius has said that much, but he was talking about the needs to cultivate trust and the benefits of cultivating that trust and that friendship. And we are all men are brothers in the world, and to put it in another language, all people. We're all part of that one community in the world. And so if we follow some of his sayings or beliefs, we come to a harmonious relationship, and it's through that that we can help others. Because if we're helping others for our own purpose, then we really lost the plot. But our help for others needs to come out of that relationship that we have. And teaching, there were seven chapters of teaching in the Chinese culture, and I won't go through all of those, but education equals good virtues. You can then pass them on to your family and your community. And again, that comes back to working out our own values so that we can pass them on. The journey of peace, a faith perspective. And peace has got so many connotations for so many people here in this room, but also in society. But peace is a safe place working in harmony. In reality, it doesn't always happen. And not doesn't always happen as we'd like, but we have the same true nature within each and every one of us. And we have a knowledge and wisdom. The challenge is that we just need to uncover that so that we can share it. Through peace, we are all God's children. And to be part of that, prayer is very, very important. And we all have the capacity to love and to show love and to show friendship. And faith is connected to the soul and the real us is our heart or our soul. And it's through that, yes, I almost think I'm repeating myself, but it's through that soul that we are able to show that compassion and justice that God showers on us and that we need to shower on others. And peace is the ultimate goal of the Torah. We need to live peace, but we also need to pursue it. We have all been created by God, by the one God, and when we show hate, we not only we distance ourselves then from God, and we distance ourselves from God. So we need to serve others regardless of where they are at. And as always, God is our beacon, our example. And then we looked at the youth initiative, and what can I say?
to the youth, you're privileged, really. You're in a space where I wish I could have been when I was your age. And so you are demonstrating an ability and an enthusiasm to tackle questions and issues that relate to you. And so probably we have, as adults, a bit to catch up to where you're at. But it's about, as you've found out and are saying, it's about sharing your stories. And as a Christian, Jesus, that's how he preached. He tells stories. And I think telling stories are powerful communication. And so I encourage you to continue to tell your story with the enthusiasm that you've got. And that, to me, is a very powerful medium. And you were sharing with us that peace is for all people, regardless of culture or religion. And I like your logo, The Next Step, and that's your name, The Next Step. And I think that is a challenge for each and every one of us, that we need to take that next step ourselves, as we, as adults, can seek to, like you are trying to do, is to create change so that, And you have found, and I encourage you, as you have found, as you've challenged and worked towards conferences or whatever the activities you have put together, that has been a learning experience from you. But learning never stops. It's something that you need to continue, because we all need to do that. And it was talked about, religion is a lifestyle. But I just want to say to the young people, there is a cliche, or I think it's a cliche, that the youth are the future. I like to say to you that the youth is today, and we're really all in this together. And while you might go about it in a slightly different way, you and your enthusiasm and your issues, and we in our way, but we're all in this together, and we need to be able to work together, and you are part of society today. So as you do that, with our enthusiasm, sometimes things don't quite work out as we'd like, so we need to be patient. There's an old saying, patience is a virtue, and that's true. And if something just falls over, not as we might like, we need to pick ourselves up and never give up and have another go. So thank you for your attention, and thank you.
Thank you, John. I think you captured very, very well the essence of the conference and what has occurred. I'd support you in encouraging that in that statement. The youth are part of the present. 30 years ago, when the Anglican Church in this diocese had youth synods, they were all the rage back then, that was the key message of the youth synods. We are part of the present as youth. We're not just the future. And I think that's an important message to keep in mind, along with the other thoughts you've provided.
I'm Mary Rose, and as John was sharing, I wrote a reflection, and it begins with, we are one, but many, divided or united, together or apart, bringing hope and peace, or destruction and hopelessness. We are one, but many, many views and voices, many hopes and dreams. Can we share these together? Can we live in harmony with each other, or strive to keep us apart? The journey and choice is ours. The path we walk alongside friends and companions, or as strangers, striving and competing. The world won't change unless I do. When I seek to see this world with new eyes of hope and love, and not despair, even though my interfaith companions are so few, yet each carries a light in the darkness that brings hope to those in despair. Can we succeed? Only with patience and perseverance, being willing to move beyond talk to action, from conference to the wider society, remembering we each carry the light of peace into the darkness of violence.
Thank you, Mary Rose. Mary Rose is from Singapore. How many times have you come to one of these conferences here in Toowoomba, Mary Rose? Twice. And certainly she, again, captures in a different way a reflection of the conference itself. Would anyone else like to offer a reflection or thought? I'd like to capture some of the essence of the conference from different, both different perspectives and also from different parts of the world. So, yeah, would you like... Yeah. I haven't had the pleasure of you of saying hello. And your name is?
Abdul.
Okay. Would you like to go up there? Or?
Yeah, that's right.
In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and merciful. Really, need of peace, unity, respect, and dignity, it was the demand of every age and every era. But today, really, we are in extremely need, and I really appreciate the organizers. They organized the event, and of course, no doubt, we practice any religion, but we all are the human being. And as a human being, we all are the brothers and sisters. And when we are the brothers and sisters, so of course, there is a tradition of Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, he said, Al-khalqu kulluhum ayalullah. All human beings, they are the family of Allah. They are the family of God. وَأَحَبُّ إِلَىٰ إِلَىٰ اللَّهِ. And the most beloved for Allah, subhanahu wa tabaraka ta'ala, is the one who give more benefit to the family and the community. So of course, this is a community service. And there is an ayah from, verse from the Quran, and I'm going to conclude, where Allah, he said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hujurat, ayah number 13, Inna khalaqnakum min zakarin aw unsa. Min zakarin wa unsa. We created you from male and female. Waj'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila. We are many, but we are one. Ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila. And we divided you in the groups and the tribe. But that division, not for the fight. That division, not for the trouble. That division to recognize each other. Like in one family, if a parent, they had the four children, they love each other, they all, but they name Joseph, Muhammad, and every family, they had the name according to their religion. But they love all these children. Same way, جَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. So at least you'll be recognized. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَتْقَاكُمْ. The one who is sitting at the chair of the president, he is the most honorable. The one who is the prime minister, he is the most honorable.
the one who is the leader of the world, he's the most honorable? No. According to the Quran, according to all holy books, in akramakum indallahi atqakum, the most honorable in the eye of God is the one who is most pious, who is the most righteous. And I'm very happy to see there are the many pious, there are the many righteous, those who are sitting here. And I'm very confident about the future of this world, where there will be peace everywhere, because our children, they believe in the peace, because religion is nothing except the peace. Because only the religion has the power to unite you. Only the religion has the power to extinguish the fire of the fight. Only the religion has the power to unite the everyone. So we all are the united. We all are the brothers and sisters. Thanks. Bye.
It's been a wonderful, wonderful time to meet people and be with old friends. So I wish you every compliment of the season as we move into a few different seasons and different calendars, but we've got Hanukkah happening right now. We've got Christmas coming up, and we've got the Christmas tree there. We've got other things occurring, and so I wish you all the compliments of the various seasons that are coming and are upon us. A safe journey home. Enjoy the party tonight.